The first encounter with an Arab Christian I had, it was in Sudan. In the hotel where I was staying, the receptionist was a Christian Sudanese. He knew that I was studying Sharia. He told me that he was studying their Sharia, theology, Christian theology. So we started to have a discussion. Once he told me something amazing and I will never forget. He told me that there is no doubt that Islam is the truth. I said to him, what? Seriously? He said, yeah, this is given. I said, why? He said to me, look, read the Quran and read any other book. He said, for example, the story of Maryam in the Quran. Read it and read the story of Maryam in any other book. You will find a huge difference between what? Between this story and that story. The story of Maryam in the Quran is very smooth, very easy, and it honored Maryam. And we as Christians claim that Maryam has a very great status and she is the mother of Isa. So she is the main personality after Isa in Christianity. Yet the way we speak to her about her, we don't honor her. But the Quran honors Maryam more than taught it book, okay? The Bible honors Maryam alayha salam. That's why it is the truth. By the way, I was thinking about the situation of this person. And one time I was thinking what to tell him. He knew that Islam is the truth. So I told him once, why don't you accept Islam? And what was his answer? It was amazing. He said that he is the son of the chief of a big tribe in south of Sudan. South of Sudan is a tribal system. And he is the son of one of the kings there. He said to me that if he were to accept Islam, he will lose power, he will lose to be the second in throne, as they say. Yeah, that he will never become the king after the demise of his father. So I was shocked. Just because of this, you reject Islam. When I was taking my luggage, checking out, I said to him, John, listen, if you feel that this life is more important, has more priority than the second life, then I agree with you that you should what? Sacrifice the second life for your position in this life. And yes, go ahead, don't accept Islam because you will be the next king. However, if the second life has more priority over this life, then what to do? Sacrifice which life? Sacrifice this life for the hereafter. Yeah? Because some people, they don't value the truth in of itself. They need an incentive to follow the truth. Anyway, I mentioned this and I left it to him.